Good evening, church, members and visitor. Welcome to our Wednesday prayer meeting. To start, may I request everyone to please stand up and to open us in a word of prayer. Let us pray. Dear God, Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for this time of worship. And we pray, Father, to guide us in your preaching of your word through giving, through the songs that we sing, and please heal our brethren who was sick, Father, and we thank you for the blessings. Forgive our shortcomings. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Remain standing as we sing our first song. Open your hymn books to page 9. Page 9, we'll be singing the song, Standing on the Promises of God. On the first verse now, ready, sing.
Standing on the promises of Christ my King, through eternal ages let His praises ring. Glory in the highest, I will shout and sing. Standing on the promises of God,
Pastor Jeremiah Solomon.
Thank you, Brother Jared. Good evening, everyone. It's time to utter your blessings from the Lord. If God bless you these past few days, we would like to hear from you so that we can be, you can be a blessing to others as well. Meron ba? Wants to share your blessing? Yeah, Sister Ma'am Elizabeth, Doctora.
Good evening, church. Just to be able to go to church is already a blessing. I also thank God for a project that was finished today. And I thank God for all the blessings that He has given to us this week. Especially now, we have an pastor who is officiating the Wednesday service. That's also a blessing. Thank you.
Amen. Praise the Lord for that. Anybody? Yeah, Sister. Sosya, Teresa, are you raising your hand? Ah, wala. Kala ko. Mga ganun ka kasi. Excited ka lang? Okay, sige. Anybody? Good to hear from you, Sister Beth. Blessing from the Lord. Sister Pilar, are you raising your hand? Hindi, nag-aayos lang. Alam naman, allergic ako pag may gumanon, you know? And, come on, we'd like to hear from you. Last Sunday, hindi kasi ako used na bumababa at kakamay doon, kasi that is your culture. Naiilang talaga ako, pero kailangan daw bumaba ako. And last Sunday, while I was shaking the hands of mga members hindi ko naman kilala, I happened to talk to visitors na nasa harapan. Yung isa doon may sakit siya, tama-tama rin yung preaching, let not your heart be troubled. And they were so blessed. They came from Negros and from Isabela. So, parang naghahanap sila ng church. Ay, hindi nila lang, but sa dinila sila ng Panginoon dito. And hopefully, they will come back this coming Sunday. And they were blessed by the preaching of God's word. And praise the Lord for that. To God be the glory for that. Nakausap ko sila. Okay, so, iba talaga ang word of God. Napaka-powerful. Some other testimonies? Sige na, huwag mahiya. Siguro pag may testimony, may bayad, mandaming magtataas. Ma'am Grace, come on. Sige po, Ma'am Grace, if you'd like.
Good evening, church. Thank you so much sa araw na safe tayo na sobrang init, pero we're all good. And thank God for last Saturday soul winning. Meron po tayong 70 na sumama po. Sa nakainitan po ng araw, nagsama-sama po tayo namigay ng tracks. And for our group, nakahiwalay kami, pero nakapag-witness kami ng 20 kids, dalawang batch po yun. Kaya salamat po sa Panginoon.
Yeah, nung Saturday, mainit, naka 20,000 steps yata. Excited, ang gandang makita yung mga bata, yung mga outreach nila. Yung iba, hindi na namin inabutan, dami namin inikutan. Sa isang barangay, 20 plus yung mga bata. Ah, sabi ko, wow. Ito yung picture when Jesus Christ was on earth. Mga street children din yung lumalapit sa kanya. Sabi niya, suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not. So masarap magturo po ng mga bata. Sabi ko sa mga reach out na teacher natin. And yan, Ma'am Grace, mainit. This coming Saturday, meron po tayong medical mission. Huh? Morning, nandito po ako niyan. And then hanggang hapon, mag-solwin tayo. Magbigay tayo ng trucks. Masarap mag-solwin, maniwala kayo sa atin. This coming Saturday, I challenge you members, if you are free, let's go soul winning, okay? Anybody who would like to share his blessing, testimony? Before we go to our 2x2 prayer, come on, yes.
Good evening, Church. Sister Merlin. Papasalamat ako sa Panginoon na naging pagpapala po yung every time po na nagkakaroon pa kami ng prayer time ng mga bata doon sa West Vigan. It's a blessing po yung may dalawa pong bata na na-invite nung Sunday. Supposed to be lima sila, pero dalawa lang po yung nagising. At nagpapasalamat po kami kasi yung mga bata nag-enjoy. Then, nung Monday po, nagkaroon po kami ng fellowship sa bahay nila ni Ma'am Judy. Pero dahil marami po mga bata ang sumama, ay sa bahay na lang po ng bata po na nag-church dito, yung pangalan niya si Denver. Doon po kami nag-share ng gospel, then nagkakantahan po at na-enjoy po ng mga bata. Napupuri po ako sa Panginoon kasi nakita ko po yung joy ng mga bata habang kumakanta, then at the same time po nakapakinig sila ng word of God at nagpe-pray po sila. Pinupuri ko po ang Panginoon sa pribilehiyo na 'yon.
Amen. Amen, brother. Sister Merlin, kasama namin nung Saturday 'yan. Ilang degrees ba nung Saturday? 40 plus ano? Sige, masarap magturo ng mga bata. Some more! Alam niyo, pag marami kang blessing, you cannot help it but share it. Come on, we would like to hear from you. Sister, mga naka-smile kayo, baka may... Sister Nora, naka-smile eh. You want to share something? Nakasmile siya, nakatitig pa sa akin. Ayan, talaga meron siyang gustong i-share.
Sige, wala naman pong special
okay.
Blessing. Siguro lang po, yung answered prayer na matagal na po namin pinagpipray. At yun po ay ang magkaroon kami ng pastor.
Yeah, I believe that, answered prayer. Alam nyo, once na pinagpe-pray natin ang mga bagay-bagay, ay maniwala kayo sa akin, the Lord will really answer the prayer natin. Basta masipag lang tayo mag-pray. Last time, another testimony, yung aming The Promise banquet sa mga kabataan. Ang goal lang namin, makareach kami ng 150. God gave us 360 visitors. nung banquet na yan. And namroblema nga kami dahil each person a-attend, 200 pesos ang sagot namin. Could you imagine, 360 yun? Kalahati lang binayaran nila. Pero it's all worth it. What is money for the life of the young people? Na masyiran mo sila ng tamang perspective about love and kung sino yung God of love. So, and we thank the Lord. Kasi yun yung bunga ng prayer. We prayed for that for many months. At ganun, nagkaroon ng victory. Okay, so I really believe the power of God in prayer. Okay? So, kung wala na, let's go 2x2. Dapat yung magiging partner nyo naniniwala sa prayer. Ha? Pag hindi naniniwala, huwag nyo ka-partner yan. Tanungin nyo muna, naniniwala ka ba sa kapangyarihan ng panalangin? Go! At this time, we are going to pray for prayer requests who are in our prayer list. As I pray aloud, I hope you are going to pray also while you are seated. These are the prayer requests that we have. Okay? So let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we thank you for tonight that we can call to you. The Bible says, call unto me and I will answer thee and show you great and mighty things which thou knowest not. And we believe that you are God who is so powerful that nothing is impossible before you. Lord, tonight we are praying for those cancer patients, Ines Castellano, Hias Morales, Sister Sonia Bacierto, Ma'am Irene Marcelo for the complete healing from throat cancer, Joe Belesa, Roma Falguera, Gisela Salenga, wife of Mark Salenga. There is an ongoing chemo for cancer. We pray for her recovery. We pray for Adelaida Navarro, mother of Sister Janet Medidas, the recurrence of colorectal cancer. We are praying for your touch upon this. Angelica Sarayu for leukemia. Sister Laurelyn Failma, healing from cancer and financial provision. Mark Agliam, praying for chemotherapy and your provision upon them financially. Lord, people who have breast cancer, I know you are going to do something with this kind of sickness. We pray for Janet Medinas, Ma'am Carol Luangco, Cory Esquilio, Susan Mapuyan, Javelin Tatel, strength and financial provision mo. Ma'am Marites Biray, strength for chemotherapy. Rebecca Capellan, salvation and healing for her. Rowena Banyas. Engelbert Noveta Auntie, we pray for the strength in her upcoming chemotherapy, Lord. Caris Marquez, wife of missionary JC Marquez, for the complete healing from her operation. The following person also, suffering from diabetes and have kidney problems, we are praying. Sister Mina Padaga, strength and your free financial provision. Promencio Capuras, Tony Ababao, Sister Elvi Giloreza, Brother Leon Cabico, Danilo Solomon, recovery from kidney problem. Dante Rodolfo, dialysis, ongoing dialysis for him. Sister Delia Yu, ongoing dialysis and your provision upon her. Marilu Bongat and Alicia Trebizonda for their dialysis. Lord, I pray that you would continue to provide their needs and for your healing upon their physical bodies. Those people who are suffering from stroke, Tony Chua, osteoporosis, Jose Tamunda, Gilmar Cabico, recovery from stroke, Sister Ramona Malapajo, Ricardo Marquez, Mrs. Frias, complete recovery from mild stroke. Even bone problem for Jocelyn Suministrado, continue to touch her. Even Enoch Roncesvalles for his cerebral palsy. Brother Willie Garcia, suffering from back pain. Sister Joyce Mayuga, that her medication will work for her. Ma'am Sherry Lontok, chronic headache and cervical spondylosis. Ma'am Lucy Lyron, good health. Bernardo Gariando, we are praying for his full recovery from aneurysm. The same thing with Lydia Abordo, complete healing from sciatic nerve pain. Dennis Durete for physical strength. Rain Ariate Bartilet, safe and healthy pregnancy for her and financial provision as well. Cheryl Di Bernardo, one of the ABBC students, for complete recovery from lupus. Zach Medidas, he has gastrointestinal complication. We pray that it will not worsen, that you would touch his physical bodies. We are praying for our pastors, missionaries working in their respective fields. We continue to pray Pastor Ariel Castro in New Zealand, Missionary Velsa Shama of Myanmar, Missionary Felix Arma and family in Ghana, Africa, Pastor Doc Apawan in Bataan for property and building, safety for our brethren in Myanmar. There is a civil matters or war going on in that country. Missionary Anthony for his deputation. Pastor Ireneo Bugtong in Iloilo, we pray for his surgery, good health, finance, and the wisdom of the doctors who will be taking care of him. Missionary Tran Darkmin and Hannah Tran, we pray for the strength, especially for the complete healing of Hannah from miscarriage. Lord, there are other prayer requests for pray for the Ukraine-Russia conflict, even current events that are happening right now in Israel. They are being bombarded by their enemies. We are praying, Lord, we know that you are sovereign. You are going to protect your chosen people. We pray for Alegria Fundamental Baptist Church for your financial provision for their church building. And this coming May 26, 2024, Karen Ormada will be taking CPA board exam, that you would remind her the things that she studied and learned. We pray for ABBC Teresa. For many years, they have no pastor. We are praying for a new pastor that is that would take care of the ministry in Teresa, a pastor that would be coming from your own heart. We pray for Odell Blanca to pass the battery exam at St. Luke's College of Nursing. Even Delia Marie Benitez, dentistry examination, theoretical exam on June 8 to 10, and practical exam on June 15 to 22. Comfort for Torrio family for the passing of Pura Torrio, together with Pastor Ortega family for the passing of Ursula Ortega, that your word may be a comfort to them. We pray for BBC Santa Mesa, for the officers and staff, that you give them wisdom. Even the absentees, touch their hearts once again, and that they may see the importance of worship every Sunday. We pray for tithes and the faith promise that this church is giving. I pray, Lord, that you would continually work within us, that we have to give what is due to you. Follow-up visitors, we are praying for them that they may grow in their newfound faith. Those Bible studies at office and respective homes, we pray for growth for the attendees, volunteers for church ministries. Continue to give them the enthusiasm to be used by you. Even our unsaved loved ones, we are praying for them that they may know thee as their Lord and personal Savior. More souls to be saved this year. We are planning for more evangelistic campaign, soul-winning campaign, street preaching campaign, and we are praying for this. Royal Christian Academy, that you would use this ministry to train more kids in Christian perspective about their studies, and continue to supply the needs of the academy as well. Asia Baptist Bible College, for this coming school year, we are praying for more students to be trained, to be prepared in your ministry. Children ministry, continue to give strength, wisdom to our Sunday school teachers, Good News class teachers, campus ministry teachers. And I pray, Lord, that they would pray that more godly generation will be raised out of these ministries. The Saya Young People Ministry, continue to prepare our young people. They are the next generation of our church, of our community, even of our country, that they may be grounded, established in the faith. Continue to bless and guide Brother Ruben in handling the young people. The Disciples and New Believers class, we continue to pray for their growth, that someday they will be able to lead others to Christ. Thank you, Lord, for listening to our prayers this evening. We know that you can do something about this. We believe that you are going to answer this according to your time and according to your terms. Continue to bless us the rest of the night, most especially the preaching of your word. Prepare our hearts. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Meron po ba tayong mga first-time visitor po? Kindly raise your hand po if you are first time visitor po. So kung wala po, shall we all stand up please? And let's welcome one another.
There's a welcome here, a welcome here. There's a Christian welcome here, hallelujah. There's a welcome here, a welcome here. There's a Christian welcome here. I love that thrill that I feel when I get together in God's wonderful people. Love the thrill that I feel when I get together with God's wonderful people. What a sight just to see all the happy faces praising God in heavenly places. What a thrill that I feel when I get together with God's wonderful people.
Please remain standing as we sing our second song. Please turn your hymn books to page 356. We'll be singing the song Sweet Hour of Prayer. Are you there? Say amen.
Amen.
On the first verse now, ready, sing.
Sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer that calls me from the world of care and bids me at my Father's throne.
Pastor Jeremiah Solomon to read us into preaching. May you please be seated.
Thank you, Brother Jer. Thank you very much. If you have your Bibles with you, please open your Bible to the book of Luke. Luke chapter 12. I'm sorry, I'm going to invite you to stand again to give respect to the Word of God. Please stand up. Luke chapter 12, beginning verse 15, the Bible says, "Follow me through your eyes as I read aloud." Beginning verse 16 of Luke chapter 12, the Bible says, "And he said unto them, Take heed and beware of covetousness, For a man's life consisteth not in the abundance of the things which he possesseth. And he spake a parable unto them, saying, The ground of a certain rich man brought forth plentifully. And he thought within himself, saying, What shall I do, because I have no room where to bestow my fruits? And he said, This will I do. I will pull down my barns and build greater, and there will I bestow all my fruits and my goods. And I will say to my soul, Soul, thou hast much goods laid up for many years. Take thine ease, eat, drink, and be merry. In verse 20, But God said unto him, Thou fool, this night thy soul shall be required of thee. Then whose shall those things be which thou hast provided? Verse 21, last verse. So is he that layeth up treasure for himself and is not rich toward God. May God bless the reading of his word. Father, we thank you for the precious word of God. We thank you, Lord, for your protection upon us. Though they're so hot out there, but again, your protection upon us is very evident. And thank you for bringing us here to worship place and to study your word and to pray for each other. Bless us with thine word. The Holy Spirit will continue illumine our understanding. Forgive us from all our sins and shortcomings. We pray all these things in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. You may be seated. Thank you very much. A rich man who is full. A rich man who is full. Probably if you're going to see the rich man, this rich man, if you're going to visit his place, sa cementerio, you would see, you can read from his epitaph, inscribed in his tomb, ang nakalagay, a rich man who is full. In verse 20, God called him full. Sa Tagalog, isa siyang hangal. Medyo malalim yun, ano? Hangal. How come that he was a rich man in verse 16, yet God called him full? I believe in our perspective, he is successful because he is a rich man. He owns a lot of fruits and goods, yet God called him full. I don't know, God called him full not because he was an illiterate person. Kasi nakapag imbak naman siya ng maraming goods niya, and I believe he's an educated person. But the Lord called him fool. And sad to say, God addressed him as fool. Pwedeng sabihan ka ng ibang tao na ikaw ay hangal, but if God addressed you as fool, there's a problem with this rich man. The Lord called him fool. And what happened to this man? Why God called him fool? Bakit tinawag siyang hangal? Napakayaman naman niya. The Lord talked to him. I want you to know, God called this man fool. He didn't realize that life on earth is temporary, so as his material treasures. Because that night the Lord will require his soul. In verse 20, this night thy soul shall be required of thee. By the way, life is uncertain in this world. Life is short. Do you believe that? In James 4:14, it records there, whereas you know not what shall be on the morrow. For what is your life? It is even a vapor that appeareth for a little time. Could you imagine? We are going to live here on earth for a little time. Maliit lang yung time natin sa earth. I don't know with you, are you going to spend your eternity here on earth? Iba gusto niyo, ako ayokong tumanda, honestly, ayokong tumanda ng 90 na yung inaalagaan ka na lang. Ayoko nun, alam niyo, ang prayer ko sa Panginoon, yung mamamatay ka, yung matutulog ka lang, tapos pagising mo, patay ka na. Iba na nakiyo yung logic, paano ka gigising kung patay ka na? And I mean sabihin, peaceful ka. hindi ka inalagaan ng mga anak mo. Ako, I pray na yung pagpagod, let's say 80 ka na, tapos peaceful ka na lang mamamatay. Tapos nakaganon ka na lang. Peaceful. Ayoko nung inaalagaan ako. That's my prayer. Sabi ko nga sa kaibigan ko, ikaw, anong wish mo pag namatay ka? Sabi niya, pag sumakay daw siya ng aeroplano, pag sumabog, edi wala na. Kasi wala siyang St. Peter's. Kaya okay na lang, sumabog na lang yung katawan. Nag-promote pa, no? Hindi. Pero alam niyo, reality of life, life is short. I don't know how are you going to live your life. Ako, I am thankful, I'm already 55. Alam niyo, pag iniisip ko yung edad ko, 55, listen, Jesus Christ died at the age of 33 and a half. Ang bata ni Jesus Christ. Kaya nga, nung pinako siya, ang lakas niya, he was just a young man. Ang tagal mamatay ni Christ, alam niyo ba, hinagupit, nilagyan ng corona and tinik. Inabot niya pa yung 6 hours, nagulat nga yung mga Roman soldiers. Because he was strong. He was just a young man. But life on earth, what is your life? It is even a vapor. How long you are going to stay here on earth? 20? 30 years? 40 years? 50 years? 70 years? Nobody knows. God called him fool. He forgot that his life is only temporary together with his material treasures. You know? Alam niyo, material treasures, hindi naman tumatagal ang kaligayahan. Example, pag bumili ka ng cellphone, mga young people, gaano tumatagal ang saya niya pag bago cellphone niyo? Cellphone ko nandun. By God's grace, ako hindi ako mahilig sa gadgets. Kahit ano yung model ng cellphone ko, kahit 33 trend, 3210, meron pa ba nun? Wala na pala nun. Basta nagwo-work, okay pa yan. Di ba pag nagkaroon ka ng cellphone, ilang months? Minsan, di ba pag nagkaroon ka ng cellphone, cellphone! Honestly, nung bumili akong cellphone, 2020, bumili akong cellphone, sumaya lang ako mga 3 araw, tapos wala na. Kunyari, meron kang bagong sasakyan. Kunyari, binigyan ka ng asawa mo ng kotse. Wow, yaman, ano? Binibigyan lang ng kotse, no? Siguro yung kotse, 1 year, masaya ka pa eh, 1 year. After nung wala na. Hindi naman siya tumatagal. Yung kotse, kinukulambuan mo pa yan para huwag makagat ng lamok. Hanggang nung nagasgasan na, all through the years, okay na yan. Why? Kasi ang temporal things, hindi yan. They don't last forever. Material things. Look at the kids. They easily get away from excitement and enthusiasm of new things. Ang bata, bigyan mo ng bagay. Yung bata, bigyan mo ng laruan, ilang minutes lang, ayaw niya na ng laruan. Kasi ang material things, hindi yan naglalast. The joy of having material things doesn't last long. And verse 19, sabi ng Bible, goods laid up for many years. All he was thinking were goods and fruits and how to build greater barn. As if he was living up to eternity. He was only thinking not only material things, pleasure. Hey soul, eat, drink, and be merry. These are temporal pleasures, and the world is mad about temporal pleasures. Anong kaisipan ng mundo? Live life to the fullest. Hey, relax. Sabi nila, don't, di ba? Life is short. Play hard. Sabi nila, no? Lalo na, basketball is life. By the way, I love basketball. Pero, hindi palagi malakas ka eh. There will come a time na tatanda ka. There will come a time ang mga pleasure. Ang mundo, lalo na pag October. Ano merong activity pag October? Oktoberfest. Alin yung Oktoberfest? Ano yung Oktoberfest? Yung iinom ng maraming beer. They enjoy worldly styles, worldly music, worldly pleasures, sex without marriage. Only at the end they will realize that they are not true fulfillment at all. Because material treasures die with you when you die. Brethren, life on earth is very short. The Lord said, thou fool. Hindi niya naisip yung gabi na yon, mamamatay na siya. What if, sabihin sa inyo, itong gabing na ito, kukunin na yung buhay nyo. Huwag naman sana. Pero reality yon. Nobody na nasa loob ng building na ito, na alam nyo pa na buhay kayo bukas. Sinong alam nyo na buhay pa kayo bukas? Hindi nyo pa alam yan. Hindi ko naman sinasabi na may mangyayari. One time sa Olonga po, after the church service, pagbaba ng member, may stray bullet, tang, tinamaan directly sa ulo. Patay. Hindi ko alam kung backslider yon o ano. Malamang backslider. Hindi, biro lang, biro lang. Kasi hindi natin alam what will happen on tomorrow. Is anybody here, you know what will happen next year? Next, I mean, wag natang next year. Next Sunday na lang kung nandirito pa rin kayo. So you cannot boast, be boastful about this. The Lord said, hey, all material treasures, all your pleasures will be gone when you die. Why God called him fool? Next, he didn't realize that his soul is more important than his material treasures. His soul is more important than material, than his material treasures. He was busy for many years storing goods, but never thought food for his soul. The flesh is full, but the soul is starving. This is a problem with this rich man. Naisip niya lang physical, but his soul is starving. In Mark chapter 8, verses 36 to 37, the Bible says, for what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? Maraming tao, they are provided materially and physically. And don't get me wrong. If you are blessed materially, physically, that's fine. Thank the Lord. Praise the Lord for that. At maraming members, you are blessed materially. Maraming Christians, they were blessed by God materially, financially. But the problem is, how about your spiritual life? Katulad itong rich man na ito. He thought na ang buhay niya hanggang doon lang. He didn't realize that his soul is more important. That's why the Lord said, yung iyong soul shall be required of thee. Sometimes, if you're going to realize about it, nga no, ang Kristiyano mayaman, pero spiritually starving, you are full. And a lot of people in this world that they are blessed materially, but they were starving spiritually. Pag nagtanong ka, nima, what's the use of magnificent house when the home is broken? Anong silbi ng magandang bahay? Kung ang pamilya naman ay sira. What is the sense of having a bachelor's degree when your life is living in immorality? What's the use of being intelligent or smart when all you've got is earthly wisdom and not wisdom from the above? And by this reason, you cannot discern what is right and what is wrong, what is godly and what is ungodly. What is the difference? What is the significance of being beauty outside when your inner life is nothing but rottenness? The soul is starving. In verse 17, the Bible says, I have no room where to bestow my fruits. Yes, the rich man is full, yet remain full because his soul is starving. According to Blaise Pascal, he said these words, there is a heart-shaped vacuum inside every human heart that cannot be satisfied by the created things, but by the Creator Himself. Kahit ganong kayaman ng isang tao, pero ang kaluluwa niya ay gutom sa salita ng Diyos. The Bible says, man shall not live by bread alone. Man shall not live by car alone. Man shall not live by dollars alone. but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. Maraming nangyari yan sa mga ama ng tahanan. You work hard for your family. You left for your family for many years. And then after that, na-miss mo yung unang hakbang ng anak mo. Na-miss mo yung unang ngiti ng anak mo. Na-miss mo yung unang pagpe-play niya ng piano because you work hard. Nakalimutan mo yung soul. And maraming Kristiyano, you work hard for your job. And I don't question you for that. But how about your soul? How about your soul, the feeding of your soul? No matter how rich you are, but if your soul is poor, then you are full before God. Kasi alam niyo, napaka-importante pa rin ma-feed ang ating kaluluwa ng salita ng Diyos. Hey, bring here a Hollywood star and God will show to him his emptiness. Bring here a basketball star and God will show to him his incompleteness. Bring here a successful businessman and God will show to him his longingness. Bring here a politician and God will show to him his uselessness. If Christ is not within, if the word of God is not within, the Lord called him fool kasi hindi niya na-realize na yung kaluluwa niya mas importante sa kanyang kayamanan. Mga tatay, yes, it is important to provide needs for our family. Pero nakalimutan natin to take care of the soul of our kids. Thou fool, the Lord was calling him fool because being rich and being famous are not the answers. It is always Christ. The living water, who can feel their thirst? It is always the bread of life, who can feel their hunger? Christ is far more important than material things. The Word of God is far more important than any material things. And we know that. Only Jesus Christ can save your soul. Only Jesus Christ can satisfy your soul. Alam niyo bakit mga masaya ang mga missionary na kahit wala silang pera? If you are going to hear the lives of missionaries, they gave up their ambition. And one thing I have to testify with you, when I was working outside as an engineer, hindi ako masaya. You know why? Wherever I go, nung na-assign ako sa Olonga po, alam niyo ba, panapumutok yung pinatubo, nandun ako. Nandun talaga ako sa Olonga po. Yun talaga. Ako, nakita ko talaga yung devastating na ginawa ng pinatubo. I was there. Napunta naman ako ang Ormoc. Di nagkaroon ng flash flood. Nandun din ako. Sabi ko, parang ako si Jonah. Ito, totoo yun. And I was reading my Bible and I perceived and I know that God was calling me to the ministry. Talagang tinatawag ako ng Panginoon, ala. Tapos, maganda yung sweldo ko. Nung nag-full-time ako sa Caloocan, ang unang, you know, hindi ako mahiyang aminin, ang unang love gift ko sa Caloocan, 150 pesos a week. Pero masaya ako. Masaya, no? Because I was fulfilling the Lord's will in my life. Ganun pala, no? Merong mga material things na hindi kayang ibigay, but only Jesus can give those things. At hindi nyo ma-question yun. Yung mga nag-full-time, they gave up their ambition. Sabi ng Bible, thou fool! Thirdly, thou fool, the Lord called him fool. He didn't realize that material treasures would have been valuable and eternal if they are not only used for himself. Look at in verse 21. Anong sabi ng Bible? In Luke chapter 12, verse 21, so is he that layeth up treasure for himself and is not rich toward God. Remember, the context of this passage in verse 15, the Lord Jesus Christ was telling to them about covetousness. In that chapter, the Lord was giving them a warning about hypocrisy of the Pharisee. And at the same time, beware of covetousness in verse 15. Kasi sabi ng Panginoon, a man's life consisted not in the abundance of the things which he possesseth. And I believe that it is not what you possess, it is what you pass. Hindi yun kung anong meron ka, kung ano yung ipinapasa mo sa ibang tao. Look at the problem of this man. Sabi ng Bible, yes, in verse 16, he was rich. Pero sabi ng Panginoon in verse 21, you are not rich because you only lay up treasure for yourself and you are not rich toward God. Within himself, there is so much selfishness and covetousness. Why? Ginawa mo lang yan sa sarili mo. Siguro sabi ng rich man, I did it myself. I did it my way. He never thought of others. There was no record of almsgiving. There was no record. Probably, pag nag-harvest siya, kinukuha niya lahat. Because in Mosaic law, pag nag-harvest ka, huwag mong i-harvest lahat para meron sa mga mahihirap. Alam niyo ba yon? Sa Hudyo, huwag silang mag-harvest. Huwag mong kunin-kunin lahat. Leave something for the poor. Pero marahil, ito, kinuha niya lahat. He never thought of others. He never thought of God. There was no record of bringing sacrifices to the temple. What is the problem of this man? He only thought of himself. Alam niyo, pag binasa niyo, he used six I will build, I, and five my. Lucifer only used five I, but this man, he used six I, ako. Anong nakalimutan itong taong to? Look at this. Nakalimutan niya, the ground, yung lupa na tinaniman niya, hindi kanya. Kaya niya bang gumawa ng lupa? The ground is not his. Eto pa, the sun, yung araw, the water, hindi kanya yon. Siya ba may-ari ng araw? Di ba para tumubo yung halaman, kailangan ng araw? Para tumubo yung halaman, kailangan ng tubig. Kaya niyo bang gumawa ng tubig? Tubig. Hindi niyo kayang gumawa ng tubig. The process of photosynthesis. Ano yung photosynthesis? Mga science dyan. Para magkaroon ng fruit, it is not its control. The seed themselves, yung mismong punla, are not his. Surely, lahat ng bagay, all things, the ground, the water, the sun, the seed, they are not his possession. They are from God. Itong hirap ang tao pag yumaman, nalagyan ng pera sa pitaka, nakalimutan nyo that everything comes from God. Your strength comes from God. The wisdom. Kaya kayo matalino sa pagtatrabaho nyo, binagyan kayo ng Diyos ng talino. Isang untog nyo lang yan.
Alam nyo, pag naantog kayo,
nakalimutan nyo lahat. Pati yung pin number nyo, nakalimutan nyo. Ubos ang kayamanan ninyo. Everything comes from God. In 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 7, for we brought nothing in this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out. The Bible is very clear, thou fool! You are fool! How come you brag about things na hindi naman ikaw ang gumawa? Thou fool, you only lay up treasure for yourself. Remember this, when God gives the blessing, forget not to give God what is due to Him. Christians, when God gives the blessing, forget not to give God what is due to Him. The tithes is not yours. Palagi kong pinapangarilan from the pulpit, the tithes is not yours. Huwag kayong magsasalita sa akin, Old Testament lang yan or what. Hey, tithes is before the law. It was strengthened during the law. And it was even in the New Testament. You know why? Minsan tinatanong ko mga members, why do you have to give your tithes? Siyempre, sasabihin nyo, well, the Lord gave me strength to work for it and 10% is belong to the Lord. You know why? Another reason. That is, sabi ng Bible, the tithes is the Lord's. Sabi ng Panginoon, ako may-ari niyan. Ibigay nyo yan sa church. Kasi yun yung gagamitin ko to propagate the gospel. Yun yung gagamitin ko sa mga manggagawa. When you give your tithes to the church, hindi kayo nagpapasweldo sa mga workers. Ang nagpapasweldo ang Diyos. Kasi Kanya yon. Gets nyo? Ang ganda ng principle ng Panginoon. Ha? So that's why you don't have the right to tell to your pastor or to your mga workers, ay, pinapasweldo ka namin. Ha? No, it is the Lord. Kasi ginagamit ng Panginoon yung Kanyang tithes. That is the Lord's property. Kailangan ibigay natin yon. Totoo to, pag di nyo binigay yan, di nyo papakinabangan yan. Whether you give it or not, sigurado to, hindi nyo pakikinabangan ng 10%. Totoo yan. Hindi ko naman sinabi, pag nagkasakit kayo, hindi kayo nagtatay. I'm not saying that, kaya nag-hold up kayo. Hindi ko alamin, kayo nakakaalam yan. Because that is the Lord's, hey, thou fool! God bless you, where is God's part? Ang bakit nga ng Diyos, 10% na lang kanya, balik na rin kaya natin. Binaligtad nga ni Mr. Colgate yan eh. Remember the story of Mr. Colgate? Ginawa niyang 90% sa Diyos. 10% na lang sa kanya. Kaya hanggang ngayon, meron pa rin Colgate and Palmolive eh. Kasi ang nagtayo niyan talagang binaligtad niya yung pagbibigay niya sa Panginoon. When you give to God, you honor Him because He made you a channel of blessing from the blessings that flow through you and you are just returning everything to Him. Everything we do, ang totoo nga naman yan, pag tayo nagbigay sa Diyos, wala namang tayo talagang naibigay. You know why? Kasi lahat naman galing sa Kanya. Bakit masasabi yung lahat galing sa Kanya? Kasi when you die, not even a single cent, pag namatay tayo, wala naman talaga tayong madadala. Well and good, naman, our earthly account is full. How about our heavenly account? Siguro meron natin ipagmayabang. Oh, ito na yung ating account. Ang dami mo account sa banko. How about your heavenly account? Your account in heaven. Remember the words of Jesus Christ in Matthew 6:19-20. Lay not up yourselves treasures upon earth, where moth and rust doth corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal. But lay up for yourselves treasure in heaven, where neither moth nor dust corrupt, where thieves do not break through nor steal. How about your heavenly account? Alam niyo, biniles kayo ng Panginoon, and I believe, etong church na ito, even, alam niyo, sa biyaya ng Panginoon sa Paranaque, antindi ng mga tao, sa biyaya ng Panginoon, maliit na church yan, pero, ibang klase. Meron isa doon after ng kanyang job, after he retired, talagang nag-tights talaga siya. Biro mo, may mag-tights sa'yo ng 1 million. Kaya niyo ibigay ng 1 million nyo, kaya niyo mag-tights. Kanya, binigyan kayo ng 10 million, kaya niyo ibigay yung 1 million. Sabi ko, pag may nag-tights dito ng 1 million, hinimatay ako. Sabi ko sa kanya, wow, you are earning your heavenly account in heaven. Alam niyo, pinagpala kayo ng Panginoon eh. Ang problema lang sa atin, hindi natin nagagamit sa Panginoon. Tinignan ko nga yung faith promise ninyo eh. Sabi ni Brother Ruben, pag nag-a-announce siya, Church, nakakalungkot naman. Kasi alam niyo, yung time dati, pag nandirito ako, ang taas niyan. Tama ba ako? Ang taas niyan. Bakit bumaba yan? Puro na lang tayo pakabig sa Panginoon? Tandaan nyo, lahat yan galing sa Panginoon. Thou fool, covetousness within yourself, I did it myself. Hey, pag tayo gumawa ng isang bagay sa Panginoon, sabi ng Bible, when you're going to give something, even a cold cup of water, in my name, a cup of water, he shall not lose his reward. Tingnan nyo ha, binabasa ko ang Bible, pag nibigay ka raw ng isang tasa ng tubig sa isang tao,
Maraming nawalan sa'yo. Nawalan ka ba nung nagbigay ka ng isang tasang tubig sa isang tao? Come on. Anybody here, you offer a cup of water to others. Have you lost something? Wala. Tama ba? Nyari may nauwa. Binigyan mo ng isang tasang tubig. May nawala sa inyo? Walang nawala sa inyo. Pero sabi ng Bible, meron kang reward kahit sa maliit na bagay na yon. Minsan inisip ko, cup of water. Paano kung nilagyan pa ng kulay yon, ginawang kape, di lalong malaki reward, di ba? Sa akin, pagpasok ko dyan sa office, palagi ako may kape, may kape. Ano, dati sa'yo yung cup of water lang, may reward na. Paano may kulay pa, kulay orange? What am I saying here? Hey, Christians, this is the context of what we are studying. How much more when you give something na nasaktan yung bulsa mo? Would you think mas greater ang reward mo sa Panginoon? Amen ba doon? Yung nag-sacrifice ka talaga, ayan na naman, mission na naman, nag-sacrifice ka, hindi mo inisip yung sarili mo. Kailan yung time na inisip mo yung sarili mo? A testimony, short testimony lang to, and I would like to praise the Lord for this. Dito ako magtatapos. Prayer meeting like this, may missionary na nag-visit sa Caloocan, hindi pa ako pastor. Ang ganda ng challenge. After that, sabi ni Pastor Samson, don't send this missionary empty-handed. Alam niyo, tinignan ko, honest to, by God's grace, I'm sharing this, wala ako yun. Pinignan ko yung pitaka ko, alam niyo yung pitaka ko, Wednesday prayer meeting ba? Alam mo ng pitaka ko, 40 pesos. Eh, may pasok pa ako sa ABBC, Santa Mesa, Asia Bible College, Bible student pa lang ako. Ang love gift pa namin, Thursday. Pag binigay ko yung 40 ko, men, wala na talaga akong pera. Sabi ko, sasabit na lang ako. Mahilig kami sumabit nila Pastor James eh. Pag wala, totoo to, sumasabit talaga kami nila Pastor Lakan. Sumasabit kami pag wala na kaming pamasahe. Ako tinutulak eh. Pasasabitin naman kami, pambino, mga nakabarong kami, naka-attache case kami. Yung pala, walang pera, no? Anyways, binigay ko yung 40 ko sa, wala na talaga. Sabi ko, wala na, Lord, wala na akong pamasahe, wala na rin ako pambili ng hopia. Yung hopia ni Ma'am Centeno, doon kami nabuhay, yung hopia, tsaka yung fountain of youth dyan. Uwi ako sa mahay, wala akong pera. Kasi, mamaya, sa paglabas ko ng church, Sir Jerry, hali kasama ka sa akin. Basta tayo pupunta, funeral service, yun ang may patay. Hindi ko rin kilala, nayaya lang ako eh. Sige, punta tayo. While I was there, lo and behold, somebody talked to me. Sir Jerry, tagal na kitang hinahanap. A young person from Caloocan. Tagal na kitang hinahanap. Sabi, bakit? May atraso ba ako? Hindi. Basta, nabibless lang ako sa young people. I was the youth director ng Caloocan. Kinamayan niya ako din. Alam niyo, pag yung mga taong kinamayan ko na matagal kong di nakita, kinakabahan ako, may naiiwan eh. Siyempre, hindi ko naman binilang. Alam ko, may blessing na naiwan. Sabi ko, ang kapal. Siguro, sabi ko, tigbe-20 to. Sabi ko, ganun. Hindi ko naman binilang. Pag uwi ko, you know why? Pag uwi ko, alam niyo, pag kuha ko, kulay dilaw. Binilang ko yung dilaw. Isa, dalawa, tatlo, apat, lima, anim. Anim na dilaw. Alam niyo na kung magkano yun. Naiyak talaga ako sa Panginoon. Look at this. Ang Diyos marunong siya. Masyado lang tayong selfish. Hindi lang sa pera, masyado tayong selfish sa time natin. Kung kailan malapit na tayong mamatay, doon tayong maglilingkod sa Panginoon. Nung samantalong nung malakas tayo, hey! Thou fool! Tonight, your soul shall be required of thee. No more tomorrow. Kaya habang malakas kayo, gamitin niyo yung buhay niyo sa Panginoon. Habang may resources kayo, maganda, magpakayamang kayo to bless other people. Oh Lord, enrich my life. Enrich my business so that I can bless other missionaries. I can bless the poor. I can bless the ministry. And I can bless my mother church. Huwag kayong mag-iisip sa sarili nyo lang. Kayong mga young people, ilang oras kayong nagbababad sa cellphone, ilang oras kayong nagbababad sa gadgets. Why not use your time to reach more kids for Jesus Christ? Thou fool! Maikli lang ang binigay ng Diyos ng time sa atin. 3 scores and 10. and it's done. Binigyan kayo ng wisdom. Nakatapos kayo ng pag-aaral. Pinagyaman kayo ng Panginoon. There's a reason bakit kayo pinagyaman. Hindi niyo yan sa sarili niyo lang. You only thought of yourself, thou fool. You're going to leave everything, but whatever things you invest in heaven, there is an eternal value for that. A rich man who is full, don't be like him. Let us all stand up. Let us pray. Lord, we just thank you for reminding us, beware of covetousness. It is not what we possess. It is what we pass to other people. Lord, tonight we acknowledge that everything comes from thee. We are only stewards of this temporal life. We are only stewards of material things, because after we die, we can never carry them in the next life. What we are doing here on earth, if it is done in heaven's eyes, then we are not going to lose our rewards. Oh Lord, help us to realize these important truths from the Bible. Christians, you can only be wise before God once you know the value of life, that it is only short. Once you know the true value of spiritual things. Once you know the true value that after this life, eternity is waiting. What's done for Christ will last. Why don't you pray, Lord, thank you for extending my life. There must be a reason. God wants to use you. God wants to use your resources. Anyway, everything comes from God. Why don't you pray, Lord, use me. If you want to come and pray, why don't you come, Lord? I don't want to be called fool by you. I want to be called a wise man. Lord, we just thank you for tonight. Thank you for your word. We glorify you for this. And continue to bless our hearts. This coming Sunday, give us another victory. Give us another souls to be won this coming Saturday in our soul winning. Continue to bless this church, more supporters, more soul winners, more people that loves the ministry, love the souls, and love this church. Continue to bless our offering this evening, for we pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. Shall I call on the ushers to please come? God bless your heart. It is blessed to give than to receive. One question. Sino hindi magsisimba sa Sunday? Uy, lahat babalik sa Sunday. Amen. Ang ganda ng tanong, ano? Lahat babalik sa Sunday. Okay, one more song, Brother JR. Come on, please all stand up.
Okay, so turn your hymn books to page 356. Page 356, we'll be singing again the song, Sweet Hour of Prayer. We'll be singing the last verse. On the last verse now, ready, sing! Sweet Hour.